We want to solve the exponential equation, give the exact solution, and the solution rounded to 4 decimal places. This exponential equation is a little more challenging than some of the other exponential equations. Notice how we have two exponential terms, and they're not like terms, and we also have this plus 7 here. So we cannot just take the log of both sides of the equation to solve for x because of this plus 7. So let's begin by focusing on e raised to the power of x plus 2. Remember the exponent rule, where if we're multiplying and the bases are the same, we add the exponents. Well, if we apply this property in the reverse order, because our exponent is a sum, we could rewrite this as e to the x times e to the second. So if we have e to the x times e to the second equals e to the x plus 7, now notice if we get the exponential terms on one side, we can factor out e to the x. So for the next step, let's subtract e to the x on both sides. So on the left, we have e to the x times e to the second minus e to the x. On the right, this would be 0, so we have equals 7. Notice both of these terms have a factor of e to the x. If it's helpful, we could write the second term as minus 1 e to the x. So if we factor out e to the x, we're left with e squared minus 1 equals 7. And now to isolate the exponential part, we can divide both sides by e squared minus 1. Now notice on the left side, this simplifies to 1. So we have e to the x equals this quotient here, 7 divided by e squared minus 1. Now that we have the exponential term isolated, we can now take the log of both sides, apply the power property of logarithms, and then solve for x. And because we have base e here, let's use natural log instead of common log. So we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. And now we'll apply the power property of logarithms on the left side, which is given here. So we'll take the exponent of x and move it to the front so that we have x times natural log e equals natural log of this quotient, 7 divided by e squared minus 1. Now most textbooks won't show this step here because natural log e is equal to 1, which we see here. The reason it's equal to 1 is because the base e raised to the first power does equal e. So because this equals 1, we have our exact solution. The exact solution is x equals natural log of 7 divided by e squared minus 1. And now we'll go to the calculator to get our decimal approximation. We have natural log of 7 divided by, we do want to put the denominator, we do want to put the denominator in a set of parentheses, so we'll have an open parenthesis e squared. For e squared, we can press second natural log. It brings up e raised to the power of 2, close parenthesis, minus 1, close parenthesis for the denominator, another close parenthesis for the natural log, and enter. So to 4 decimal places, x is approximately 0.0913. Let's take a moment and check our solution. If we sub this value in for x, the left side should be approximately equal to the right side, and I say approximately because this is a rounded solution. But it is much easier to enter than the exact solution. So e raised to the power of 0.0913 plus 2, this value should be approximately the same as e raised to the power of x, which is 0.0913, close parenthesis, plus 7. And notice how the values are approximately the same. They would be exactly the same if we did use the exact solution. I hope you found this helpful.